डोनाल्ड ट्रंप फायर स्टीव बैनन बट बैनन स्टिल वोन। President Donald Trump dumped chief strategist Steve Bannon on Friday, ending weeks of speculation that just such a dismissal was in the works. The decision will be met with the jubilations within the Republican establishment, who viewed Bannon with a mixture of loathing for his assault on them as a head of Breitbart News and fear for his influence over Trump. That joy could well turn to ash in their mouths, shouts to Taylor Lannister's. Why? Because although Bannon would not work in the White House any longer, his worldview and mindset have been adopted almost in toto by the one person whose opinion matters in this White House, Donald John Trump. Bannon, because a formal advisor to then candidate Trump on August 17, 2016, but his influence on Trump's thinking fair predates that. The two men met via conservative activist David Bossi in 2011 when Trump was mulling the possibility of running for the president in 2012. As far back as July 2015, Trump was tweeting favorably about Bannon, and Breitbart News is much smarter than Sleepy Eyes chuckled. NBC says, thanks to Steve Bannon's and Rear reporters, Trump tweeted on July 21, 2015. 5 days earlier, Trump tweeted out a praiseworthy Breitbart piece written by Bannon, headlined "Time to Get Tough: Trump's Blockbuster Policy Manifesto." Remember too that Trump has openly admitted he lacked any set policy views prior to his decision to run for president. He has been a Democrat and independent before announcing that he would run for president in 2016 as a Republican. His entire interactions with politics had been transactional. He wanted to curry favor with politicians, so he gave them money. It was entirely unideological. Breitbart and Bannon in particular gave Trump a policy architectures on which to frame his beliefs. That's not to say that Bannon alone is responsible for Trumpism, but is to suggest there was a fated convergence between Bannon and Trump at a time when Trump was looking for words and policy proposal to shape his loosely formed ideas. Bannon and Breitbart were there to supply them by their ink barrel. Bannon did not invent Trump, but he amplified him bigly. Consider Trump's suspicions of a globalism as evidenced by decisions to pull the U.S. out of the Paris Climate Accords is a hallmark of Bannonism. Trump's hardline on immigration, legal and illegal, a belief long voiced by Bannon and his fellow nationalist. Trump's hatred for the media, that distrust for mainstream media, was the driving force for Andrew Breitbart's decision to start a conservative news site with his name on it 8 years ago. It's what Bannon said about the press earlier. This year, it is going to get worse every day for the media. If you think the press are giving you your country back without a fight, you are sadly mistaken. He is also called the press the enemy and the opposition party. Trump's both sides defense of Charlottesville. Bannon has long insisted that left is just as violent, if not more so, than the right, and he's also shown a willingness to push the rhetorical boundaries on race following controversy over Trump's both sides' remarks on Tuesday. Bannon told the New York Times, "Just give me more tear down, more statues. Say the revolution is coming. I can't get enough of it." if there is a connective tissue to the beliefs Trump has espoused in the White House, it is a disdain for the rejection of political correctness. While that comforts with the Trump's natural instincts, he has also viewed himself on outside looking in, mocked by elites who would not accept him. The full flowering of Trump's nationalistic populism can be traced directly back to Bannon. Trump has had the need to Bannon water them and made sure they got enough sun. The full bloom Trump you have seen over the last week is because of what Bannon did over the past several years inside and outside of Trump's inner circles. Speaking of Trump's outer circles, don't assume that simply because Trump has filed Bannon as his chief White House strategist that their relationship is over. Trump is someone who loves to call on all sorts of people inside and outside the White House for advice. And as Trump supporters and former Georgia Congressman Jack Kingston noted on CNN on Friday afternoon, Trump and Bannon believe in the same things. Bannon may be gone from the White House, but his influence would not be disappearing anytime soon. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and share my video.